Good evening. We'll begin the graduation ceremony in about 5 minutes. Please make sure that your cell phones are on silent or turned off. You're allowed to take as many pictures as you would like from where you are sitting or standing. At no time during this evening will spectators be allowed on the gym floor. Thank you for joining us for this graduation event for the class of 2023. Please rise once the processional begins and remain standing for the singing of the national anthem, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance and invocation. Thank you.
to start?
Loud, loud.
Really loud.
On your breath?
Oh, we don't see? Okay.
On your breath?
All right, let's go.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Man, hey, yo, we did it. It's done. Let's go sit down, my brother. We have to play.
Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please remain standing for our invocation given by Mackenzie Perry.
Please bow your head. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you today for the family, friends, and graduates who gather this evening. We pray you bless this crowd in the years to come. While one chapter has closed, a new chapter eagerly awaits. With graduating comes freedom, yet let us remember to put you in the center of our lives, the center of our decisions, and the center of our future. While we are not always thankful, let us remember that you are the King of Kings. The memories, friendships, and family gained would not be possible without your grace and mercy. Lord, we thank you for the many blessings you have provided, not only throughout the 4 years of high school, but in the many years of our lives. Lord, we thank you and ask for your continuous love over the obstacles we may face. Let us have a soft and tender heart for you, Lord, and protect us through our journey in the future. We love you, and in Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Y'all may be seated. Well, good evening. I am Matt Strode. I'm the principal of Chapel Hill High School. I'd like to welcome everybody here tonight, whether you're in person or whether you are watching us on the live stream. Welcome to the commencement exercise for the 2023 school year. At this time, I would like to recognize a few people that are extremely important to the Chapel Hill Independent School District. At this time, I'd like to recognize our school district board of trustees, and if you would please stand as I call your name, Mr. David Acker. Mr. Fred Elder Jr. Dr. Amy Hayes. Mr. Herschel Massenberg. Mr. Ricky Mosley. And our board president, Les Sminky. I'd also like to recognize our superintendent of schools, Mr. Lamon Dean. I'd also like to recognize our administrative team, our associate principal, Ms. Christy Murray. Our assistant principals, Ms. Linda Godwin. Mr. Mark Hegman, Ms. Laura Helm, and Mr. Reggie McGowan. I'd also like to take this time to recognize our counselors, Ms. Julie Chance, Mr. Brad Hickman, Ms. Laura Varnado, Ms. Kelly Wilkes, and our CTE coordinator, Ms. Leanne Crump. Any members of the Chapel Hill High School faculty and staff as well, please stand. Thank you. Y'all may be seated. At this time, I'd also like to recognize a few other people. I would like to thank Hanson Imageworks for producing our programs tonight, so thank you to them. I would like to thank TJC for allowing us to use their gymnasium this evening. And a special thanks to EDQ Maintenance and Smith Irrigation for donating the tickets for us tonight. And lastly, I'd like to thank three ladies that I could not live without. They are in charge of setting up for this event tonight, Ms. Lori Blair, Ms. Libby Lamon, and Ms. Sarah Apperly. So this weekend we celebrate not only graduation, but we remember those that have fallen in service to our nation and her defense. So if you would, for just a brief moment, please join me in a moment of silence as we honor these heroes. Thank you. Also, if you are a veteran or currently serving in the armed forces, if you would, please stand so that we could recognize you and your service to our country. At this time, I would like to welcome to the stage our senior class president, Ms. Hillary Christ.
Good evening. My name is Hillary Christ, and I am the president of the class of 2023. It is my pleasure to welcome all the family, friends, board members, administrators, faculty, and staff of Chapel Hill ISD. Thank you all for taking time out of your busy lives to come support the class of 2023. You should all be very proud of all the accomplishments of the graduates who sit before you. We are moving on to fulfill our goals and chase our dreams, but without your constant guidance and support, we would not have made it this far. On behalf of the class of 2023, we appreciate all you've done and will continue to do for us. Thank you for joining us today, and welcome to the graduation ceremony of the class of 2023.
At this time, I would like to introduce our salutatorian of the class of 2023. Our salutatorian is Ms. Megan Ray. Megan is the daughter of David and Holly Ray. Megan had a grade point average of 117.31, and she will be attending UT Tyler. Megan, please come forward and accept your salutatorian award from Mr. Hickman.
Thank you. First off, I'd just like to say thank you to all the teachers and staff that have worked hard and influenced all of us throughout the years. We wouldn't be the people we are today without you, and I just want you to go home tonight knowing how much we all appreciate you. I'd also like to say thank you to all the friends and family in the stands right now. Hi, Mom. Our community has been filled with support for as long as I can remember, and I'm really grateful for everyone here to support this year's Chapel Hill graduates. But more importantly, I'd like to thank all of my peers that will be walking the stage with me tonight. These faces have shaped my youth, and there are so many things to admire about this group of students. From their academic and athletic achievements to their character, I've witnessed several amazing accomplishments by my peers. I think one of the greatest qualities I've noticed in all of you is your creativity. Whenever faced with challenges, both big and small, I've noticed the way you've thought outside the box and pushed yourself to exceed all expectations. It's amazing how we're all able to come together and get through any obstacle in our way. The environment we've built at this school is so supportive, and it's been an honor growing up alongside such an amazing group of students. You all have taught me how to care for others and allowed me to feel a sense of community every day. But even more than that, you've influenced me to persevere through anything without losing sight of my goals. Y'all are some of the most hardworking people I've ever met, so thank you for granting me a high school experience I'll never forget. With that being said, our transition from high school into whatever comes next will be full of challenges. But knowing y'all, everything will work itself out. For some of us, we get to enjoy summer and then jump right back into school. Yay. For others, we'll find our place through family, through work, through the military, or just by taking advantage of any opportunity that's presented in front of us. But no matter what you plan to do after today, I think we all have one thing in common, and that's that we don't really know what we're doing. But that's okay, because we're just gonna keep pretending we do until one day we wake up and we realize, hey, I kinda do know what I'm doing. Until then, I have no doubt that we will continue to persevere and build upon the values that this community has instilled upon us. Values such as courage, integrity, determination, leadership, friendship, and compassion. As we begin to move forward with our lives, I'd like to say one more congratulations to the Chapel Hill class of 2023. Now please welcome Ms. Linda Godwin, our assistant principal.
Good evening. At this time, I would like to recognize the awards and honors our graduates have received as high school students. You will notice that many of our graduates have different stoles and cords that they have been awarded. Graduates wearing gold stoles represent the top 10% of the 2023 graduating class. Would the top 10% please stand? You may be seated. Will those wearing red cords please stand? Each senior who is standing donated blood at least twice this year during the Student Senate blood drives on our campus in coordination with the Carter Blood Care Center. Thank you, seniors, for giving the gift of life. Please have a seat. Graduates wearing gold stoles represent the top 10% of the 2023 graduating class. Would the top 10% please stand? I already said that, right? National Honor Society members are wearing white collars. NHS members, please stand. You may be seated. Students in early college high school have red, blue, and gold cords. They also have medals for earning 15 or more dual credit hours, and 23 of these students received their associate's degree from TJC on May 12th, 2 weeks prior to graduating from high school. Early college high school students, please stand. You may be seated. Students who took dual credit courses from the University of Texas, Austin, feature orange and silver cords. On-ramp students, please stand and be recognized. You may be seated. Will the graduates wearing gold honor cords please rise? These seniors wearing gold honor cords have a cumulative grade point average of 90 or higher and are graduating on the foundation of Distinguished High School Graduation Plan. Congratulations, seniors, on this significant accomplishment. You may be seated. Three-year graduates, please stand and be recognized. 3-year graduates, please stand and be recognized. You may be seated. Students who are entering military service, please stand. Thank you for your dedication. Students have qualified for state in any extracurricular program during your high school career. Please stand. You may be seated. Students who have qualified for nationals in any extracurricular program during your high school career, please stand. You may be seated. Associate Principal Christy Murray will come and recognize the honor graduates from career and technical education.
Good evening. National Technical Honor Society members are wearing purple and silver cords or silver stoles. NTH members, please stand. You may be seated. Graduates who are wearing maroon cords represent participation as future health professionals. HOSA members, please stand. You may be seated. The Texas Association of Future Educators are wearing red and blue cords. TAFE members, please stand. You may be seated. Our Future Farmers of America students are wearing blue and gold medals. FFA members, please stand. You may be seated. Chapel Hill High School is proud to announce this evening that this school year we have 290 industry-based certifications completed by our graduates. These students have earned certifications in health science, welding, construction, engineering, cosmetology, graphic design, audio-video production, animal and plant science, culinary arts, information technology, and education. Seniors wearing black cords have received an industry-based certification, while those who are certified and completers in their program of study are wearing black and silver cords. Students who have received an industry-based certification, please stand.
Y'all may be seated. It's an honor to recognize our next speaker. She is the valedictorian of the class of 2023. She is the daughter of Miss Stacy Kerbo. She's going to be attending Texas A&M University Corpus Christi. She had a grade point average of 117.67. That's Miss Mackenzie Peary.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. What a pleasure it is to be here today. What a pleasure it is to finally say we did it. We finally finalized this chapter, and it's time for us to move on. But before I start, I would like to thank the many people who have crossed my path on this journey, many who are here with me to stay. To the select group of teachers, administrators, coaches, friends, athletes, family, and the ones who have became it, I genuinely would like to thank you. To my siblings, to the Steele family, to the Dahlgren fam, to Chad, Coach Riley, and Mr. H, your unwavering love and support has gotten me this far, and I couldn't be more thankful for you all. No words can express my love, gratitude, and appreciation for all of you. If I have learned anything, it's that I'm not alone. The other day, I got home late, and my niece ran to the door, and she gave me the biggest hug. She says, "Kinsey, I want to be just like you when I grow up." Both in actions and in words, I have learned what it feels like to live through care, compassion, and most importantly, love. The list continues, and to the ones out there who I have not yet mentioned, you know who you are, and for that, I say a big and honest thank you. Starting this speech, I stared at a blank computer screen for several days, indecisively annoyed with an empty mind. What do you do when there's a million things to say, yet no words? I could share my speech and leave you all with a personal anecdote of my life, a personal anecdote of the challenges, but instead of rambling on about the toughness of making it this far, the most important part is the gain. As someone would say, a lesson learned is a lesson that should be shared. And so today, I have four of them for you all. Number one, put God first. It's number one on my list, and it should be number one on yours too. If you would have asked me this just 1 year ago, this would not be my number one, not be in my top four, and probably in no list of mine. But although I have not always stuck beside God, He has always stuck beside me. If we move on, forget who we are, and leave the most important thing behind, then we are nothing. But if we stick through it by Him, then we are everything. Everything you think you see in me, everything that I've done, everything you see now is because of Him. Because without Him, I am nothing. So in everything you do, put God first. Number two, thank you. Number two, pick up your pen. We all have this huge book sitting in front of us, and for most, you have made it to chapter 18. But let's not end it there. Pick up your pen and fill the empty pages. Make some memories. Step out of your comfort zone and live a little. Actually, live a lot. And sorry to the teachers who experienced our living a lot at our senior prank. I read something the other day, and it said, life is not measured by the number of breaths you take, but the number of moments that take your breath away. Parents, staff, family, graduates, and distinguished guests, I ask that you all look around. Sitting before me is a room full, very full, of unique individuals about to jump off the last step and into the world. A world of freedom, a world of decisions, and a world of choice. In Proverbs 16, it says, the heart of man plans his way, but the Lord establishes his steps. You may not have the access to decide how many chapters are in your book, but you have the power to make each one you're blessed with to hold value, to be authentic, to be remembered. Saying this, pick up your pen and make some memories. Number three, perspective. As humans, we set high expectations. We want certain things to happen exactly the way we want them to. But if you haven't noticed already, we will be let down. We will never be able to envision our life ahead. We will never get a sneak peek of what we collide with. But my question is, what if it can turn out better than you can imagine? A part of being human is that many of us simultaneously feel emotions differently. We may not always get to decide how we feel, but we can decide how to see it. Many times we learn happiness through sadness, compassion through suffering, and love through loss. The most beautiful things out of the most terrible situations. It's all about perspective, so how will you see it? Number four, last but just as important, dominoes. If you ever played with dominoes, your selection is unique. Each one with different numbers, used at different times. And this represents us. Different in our own way, but it also represents our choices. If you have ever lined up dominoes in a line and let one hit the other, you know what I mean. We are about to hit a stage in our life that's new. New places, new people, and new opportunities. When you make one choice, that domino falls over and hits the next. We will make a boundless amount of choices in our life that will affect our future, one after the other. and it's up to us to decide which life we would like to live. The very thing that helps some succeed leads others to fail. And while I cannot sit here and tell you how to become successful, I can say the person sitting next to you has as good of a shot as you do. To live out the most deepest, most dynamic way of life, we must make these decisions carefully. It's no one's life to live except our own. To all of you, take a look around and enjoy this moment. A look at the people you may never see again. Although we may lose touch, the memories we share will never die and will truly last a lifetime. Class of 2023, we did it. We're here. And again, thank you.
Please join me in moments of reflection. We arrived at Jackson or Wise on the first day of school. Our parents walked us in with new clothes we thought were cool. To our classes we went, ready for recess, where time was well spent. Little were we prepared for the trips we would take and all the good memories with friends we would make. Field trips with sack lunches and different colored shirts, watching our classmates roll around in the dirt. Thank you, Jackson and Wise, for all the fun, but before we knew it, our time was done. These were the places where we got our first start, the foundation to help us pursue the dreams of our heart. We will always hold dear the memories of those years.
Kiss him. On to new grade levels, here we go. We don't have to wear uniforms, let's go. It's the first day of school, we all have to look cool, backpack full of supplies, but today's the day, so that was no surprise. Jump rope for heart and the pacer test too, worry-free with less attitude. Slides, swings, and monkey bars very tall, the burning metal and blistering hands, but we know that was most fun of all. Oh, how recess was a blast, but it always moved so very fast. But now we are fifth graders, the rulers of the hallways and classrooms too. Who could forget the past? Kiss Am, you were a blast.
On the first day of middle school, we all walk in nervous. We straighten the collar of our polo, knowing for our fashion sense they were doing us a disservice. Luckily for us, Fridays came with socials and t-shirts. Some kids were running around the pit, while others were being total flirts. As sixth graders, we were the lowest of the low. Metal mouths and red faces, we tried our best to fit in, to find our places. In seventh grade, we finally found our flow, joining clubs and groups and knowing where to go. Finding our passions in sports, dance, theater, art, band, and many more, we finally began to look up and stop looking at the floor. We were still weird and awkward as we grew, and we were not the top dogs yet. We were still waiting on our breakthrough. When we followed into eighth, we were confident and bold. We felt like we were all that because we thought we were getting old. Tests were getting harder and we began to stress. The same year, we started to taste a little bit of free dress. Because all good things have their end, it was time to say goodbye to all of our friends. We sat in the cafeteria in alphabetical rows as our eighth grade year was finally at its close. No more lockers or polos. We didn't need that where we were going. We were off to high school now. Let's get this ball rolling.
High school. Freshman year, the year that got cut in half. Sanitizer masks, we did not imagine all of that. Spring break turned into summer. However, we weren't prepared for all of the bummers. Online school was okay, and Zoom became our everyday. Sleep, TikTok, and whipped coffee, those became our everyday hobbies. Freshman year was quickly over, then came sophomore year, dragging us forward, walking into a new normal. Mask on, they yelled halfway down the hall, and still people attending via Zoom call. So over the 6 feet rule, counting down the days till we can jump in the summer pools. Finally, underclassmen we no longer were, and honestly, junior year was just a blur. Classes got harder and days longer, but we held on and tried harder. Junior year is when we had to step it up and start to realize we're no longer little pups. It was time to saddle up and tighten the ropes and push through to that little light of hope. This is it. Senior year came fast. Time to begin all of our last. Senioritis was strongly and frankly, this moment was not easy to achieve, but nothing compares to the love and memories that we will leave. Some may be anxious, some of you might not know what to do, but in Jeremiah 29:11, God declares, "For I know the plans I have for you." Now here I stand reading these rhymes. Well, class, now it's our time. Mr. Strode and Mr. Dean will now certify the class of 2023.
Graduates, if you would, please stand. As principal of Chapel Hill High School, I certify to you, Mr. Dean, that these 211 students have completed the coursework required by the Texas Education Agency to receive a diploma or certificate of completion in the state of Texas.
As superintendent of Chapel Hill ISD, I accept the certification of these 211 graduates. Congratulations, students.
Mr. Dean, will you and the Board of Trustees please come forward and join me in awarding the high school diplomas? Students, prepare to receive your diploma.
Mackenzie Jordan Peary. Megan Nicole Ray. Alexis Ruby Young. Victoria Rose Combest. Keisha Grace Huncy Knight. Wesley Mack Wilt. Annalise Marie Flores. Jared Emmanuel Sanchez.
Alexandra Jasmine Velez.
Aiden Sayer.
Brianna Xiomara Valencia. Natalie Jeanette Ibarra. Juan Torrescano.
Isaiah Eights.
Jacqueline Lugo.
Keely Jacobs. Carly Raylin Williams.
Jenny Ramirez.
Good job.
Nicolás Sebastián Durán.
Akayla LaTatiana Manning. Ella Bagwell.
Giselle Galarza.
Hillary Elizabeth Christ. Savannah Marie Solis. Larry King Jr.
Lady Jasmine Abonza. Edgar Daniel Acosta. Diana Itzel Arrigue.
Almotasim Bela Almanasir.
Brian Alvarez. Anthony Javier Anda. Angeline Andino. Hatsava Argote.
Brian Anthony Ariola. Caden Ashley. Ryan Austin.
Sebastian Avila. Jonathan Rosales Perez. Freddy Baldazo.
Peyton Wayne Baxter.
Kelsey Brianne Benitez.
Colton Bentley. Tyson Berry. William Bevel. Sean Bias. Christian Glenn Lamar Blevins. David Bollinger. Dakota Luke Bonaire.
Matthew Borja.
Jada Bowens.
Anaya Renee Bowie.
Duncan Montgomery Davis. Madison Renee Bradshaw. Emma Brewer. Kayla Brooks. Austin Burris. Jacob Cabral. Brandon Lane Caffey.
Gianni Gampa. Roxana Carreño. Alex Chavez. Alondra Beatriz Chavez.
Jaden Cole. Christy Jane Colazzo. Kaya Simone Dion Cook. Tyrese Cooper. Emery Lanier Creighton. Naya Ayana Daniels. Zachary Jean Davenport.
Mariana Diaz Saucedo.
Danny Lee Doan. Shatira Descharnay Dotson. Reagan Drummond.
Ana Duran. Gerardo Duran.
Gerardo Duran. Leighton Gerard Apudaca. Kevin Wilson.
Leonel Espinosa.
Jaylee Eubanks. Kaleo Kealoha Okalai Jeremiah Fala. And Jeremiah is the one I got wrong. Hamza Farah. Carly Renee Finch.
Daniel Fuentes.
Isaiah Gales.
Brianna Galindez. Israel Alexander Galindo Cruz Jr. Damian Noe Garay. Lisette Garza.
Shelby Gilliland.
Felipe Gonzalez Suazo.
Crystal Rivera. Jalen Deshaun Green.
Jair Guerrero. Jane Guillen.
Cameron Elise Shanae Hampton. Drew Harmon. Abigail Hatton. Sierra Henderson.
Cristal Leila Hernandez. Luis Hernandez. Stephanie Denise Hernandez.
Ashlyn Hill.
Mm-hmm.
Kevion Huddleston. Brianna Humes.
Gustavo Jaimes.
Dariana Shania Jenkins.
Raimundo Jimenez Cuevas.
Mariah Joycelyn Jonigan. Articia Zykea Johnson. John Kennedy Jr. DJ Kincaid. Justin David Lambert.
Adrian Lara Jr.
Zebediah James Light.
Amadeo Lopez. Edgar Lopez. Jesus Lopez. Joshua Lopez. Oscar Lopez. José Alfredo Lozano III. Diego Daniel Lucatero. José Julián Macías Rodríguez.
Trinity Nora Mahan.
Luis Maldonado Garcia.
Mia Kate Marmon. Brianna LaRue Martin.
Abel Martinez Robles. Alexis Elena Martinez. Judith Betseida Martinez Morales.
Giovanni Ava Massey. Hugh Maritho. Alonzo Renard McGregor II.
Oscar Antonio Mesa.
Caden Miller. Shania Danielle Miller. Cameron Alexis Miner.
Alan Odi Mondragon. Carlos Leonel Moreno. Liana Destiny Morin.
Adrian Joseph Mumphrey. Jatiron Buna Mumphrey.
Abril Muñoz.
Sha'Asia Renee Neal. Dat Nguyen. Natalie Norman. Joshua Inwachuku.
Andrea Ortega. Joanna Maritza Ortega Acosta. Giselle Ortiz.
Alan Owens. Brianna Pennell. Malcolm Pasama.
Collins Patricio. Emily Giselle Perez. Brandy Pineda. Calvin Ponce Mejia. Joel Ramirez. Brenda Rangel Pineda.
Logan Ray. Kelsey Reed. Amaya Rimbert.
David Adriel Santibáñez. Edith Alexandra Reyes Villas. Ángel Ríos. Gabriela Rivera. Layla Marines. Aviceli Rodriguez. Dulce María Rodríguez García. Rodrigo Rodríguez.
Alexia Raquel Roger.
Natalie Michelle Ruiz. Carmen Sanchez. Paola Sanchez.
Damarian Keyshawn Sanders. William Cade Scoggins. Ja'Cory Seaton. Dalton Self. Logan Sexton. Shyla Marie Starks. Scott Sturck. LaDamian Thompson.
Edwin Torres. Luis Torres Perez.
Keelan Jamal Tuck. Brandon Tucker. Nathan Luke Tucker. Vincent Tucker Jr. Anaya Uday.
Elba Vallecillo Cárcamo. Seleni Vallecillo Cárcamo. Austin Emilio Vega. Rubén Velasco.
John Allen Bryce Venturka. Daniel Waddleton. Atlantis Walker. Elizabeth Wallace. Jothia Walton. Camille Whitaker. John White. Logan Von Wilhite. Jaquan Williams. Travis Williams. Brianna Asai Willis Goodlow. Jackson Yarbrough. Destiny Nicole Young. Jeremy Enzel.
Andres Zavala.
Trinity Payne.
The graduation tassel is a symbol for success. Some believe that the reason why the tassel is on the right side is because you've earned the right to graduate. Moving the tassel to the left side after graduating is symbolic of crossing over from high school to the next stage of your life. Graduates, at this time, please move your tassels from the right to the left. In just a minute, our seniors are going to exit. So please remember that nobody is allowed on the gym floor afterwards. Your graduate will come to you. The exits are at the side over here. And so to our graduates, our parents, and community, congratulations on a job well done. If you would, please rise for the benediction, alma mater, hat wave, and then the recessional for our graduates.
Please stay standing for the benediction. Dear Heavenly Father, I want to thank you so much for this amazing group of students that sits before me. You have blessed us with so many friends and good memories over the years, and I pray that we will cherish them forever. Lord, as we begin to explore our lives, my hope is that we take our gifts that you have blessed us with and use them to the best of our abilities. I thank you for all of the doors that you have opened for our futures, and especially for guiding us around all of the doors that have closed. No matter where our future takes us, Lord, I pray that we will always use your compass to guide us through uncertainty. I love you so much, Lord, and in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
My name is Natalie Ibarra, and I am here speaking on behalf of the senior class. It is such a pleasure to share the intensity of emotions that fill Wagstaff Gymnasium tonight. Graduates, as you look back on all the memories you have made and close this chapter of your story, remember that you are now entering a new one. Wherever you go and whatever you do, remember that graduation is not the end, it's the beginning. Knowing this, I encourage you to keep this quote in mind. The scary news is, you're on your own now. The cool news is, you're on your own now, by Taylor Swift. Class of 2023, you're dismissed.
Get it now. Ooh, I want the time of my life. Yeah. Oh, baby. Ooh, give me the time of my life. wanna see that thing drop. From the back to the front to the top. You know me, I'm off in the cut. Always like a squirrel, looking for a nut. This is up for show, I'm not talking about luck. I'm not talking about love, I'm talking about lust. Now let's get loose, have some fun. Forget about bills in the first of the month. It's my night, your night, our night. Let's turn it up.
I knew my rent was gonna be late about a week ago. I worked my ass off, but I still can't pay it though. But I got just enough to get off in this club and be a good time before my time is up. Hey, let's get it now.
Tough times, believe me, been there, done that. But every day above ground is a great day, remember that. Bye. Catch a case and watch my future.